Hi everybody. Today I was wanting to talk a lot more about the farming situation in the United States and make this as fun as possible. There's just a lot of things where as we study something, it can really change our lives in amazing ways, and we can actually do some really different stuff with our life. So what I wanted to suggest here is that at all levels, whether you're looking for good work, or you're looking for housing, or you're looking for food, or just clean water, it all kind of goes back to what we're studying here in the food situation. So it's a very important topic, and it definitely can make your life a lot better. And we're going to look at the details here in a second. First of all, let's start about where is the farmland in the United States. And from this map, you can basically see that maybe your perception of the United States is not correct. In fact, there is actually not very much farmland in the United States. In fact, California produces about 80% in many categories, or even 90% of a lot of the food. And that's this region here, as well as here, and then these other regions down in here, including up into Canada. So actually, believe it or not, the United States has less farmland than India. And we're gonna look at some details, but essentially it's maybe surprising to you. The other surprising truth is, look at this map. Notice how every single thing is squared out. Everything has been farmed. The other misconception is, not only is there not as much farmland in the United States as you might think, almost everything has been farmed, like in India or even in China. So it's really, if you think, oh yeah, there's gonna be some farmland for me somewhere, look at this map, and if I even zoom out a little bit, you can start to see it's vast. It's just, you know, this is hundreds and hundreds of miles and basically completely farmed. So this map, if you look at this map and this map, you'll notice that the farmland pretty much sticks to exactly where you'd think on this map. And basically it's next to impossible to farm in the desert and other regions like you see here, and that's why there's no farmland. So we're gonna look at that as well. So what I wanted to do though also is to look at everybody here and say that, you know, we're all responsible for trying to figure out how to live on this planet and treat our food very well. Oftentimes, when I'm cooking food, I think of it like really spiritually, and I try to like very carefully, you know, handle my food. I'm very cautious with the water as it comes from the sink, and different aspects of everything. You know, it all starts with how we actually, if you're not a farmer, it even matters how you pick up your food, being nice to the food. All those factors actually go back to the root of the problem and the solution, right? So anyway, so what I wanted to show you is this map too. So you can see that there's actually quite a lot of farming up into Canada. And the surprising thing is that a lot of people say, oh, well, Americans are some of the best farmers in the world. That is simply maybe not true at all. In fact, a lot of our food comes from either California and actually significantly from Mexico, even more so from Mexico. And some of the best farmers in the world are actually Mexicans and Californians, as well as people in the Southwest, down here in Memphis, Louisiana, and Florida, and Southeast. And actually, some of the worst farmers in the world are in the Midwest, as we'll start to see, because they're actually just doing very simple kinds of farming relative to what they're doing in other areas. But again, this is about working together and really understanding what's going on. So again, you can see from this map, you can see the shape of this farmland here and the farmland here. that basically it's showing that there is actually a lot less farmland than you think. And in fact, India has more farmland than the United States. So, the soil map is very interesting because you start to see there's a region down here in the southeast that is actually very farmable, that we're actually not farming very much at all in the United States. So there is some hope in this discussion, particularly down here. However, there's a big argument with forestry on this. And in fact, maybe what they should do is reforest the West and keep focusing on foresting this region, as well as working on forestry in this region. But it's an important discussion. Here you can see that India is entirely farmed out, every single square inch. And if we change this to a map with satellite, you'd notice that this is a desert, and that's why it's not farmed. So essentially everything has been farmed entirely. So before we get into this discussion, I'm going to pause here. So I really wanted to try to work with people on this. So as we're looking at this, let's try to work on these ideas. I'm planning on many different aspects, changing many different aspects of my life and even my social life, to working with people that are closer to the farming regions and focusing heavily on food. So, but what I wanted to start by telling you is, remember that fact. If you notice, almonds, 90%, 90%, 98% of pistachios, oranges, 80%. California is producing almost everything when it comes to produce for the United States. So this map here, believe it or not, we can do a lot better. And this is what really shocked me, right? California is actually struggling in a way that is unbelievable. And we're going to see some of the vastness of some of the farmland that has been devastated and actually is no longer even farmable because it's turned to sand in the Central Valley. So, but my point here is that this piece of farmland, this pink soil in here, is actually what they're farming. We get great quality soil all the way up into the Midwest, but it's just not warm enough to farm in the wintertime. So they can farm year-round in California as well as they can farm year-round in many parts of the South. So there is a vast question of why do we have to beat up California like this? So as we look at this, you're going to see that the discussion is going to be primarily, at least initially, about California. But we're going to look at also this area in here, Memphis, down here in Louisiana, Florida, the Southeast, and then look at all this Midwest stuff, which is basically the most vanilla farmland that you can possibly imagine. Corn forever, basically. So this is all corn through here. But and then you can see, we'll actually look into New York City a little bit. And then actually look at the Northwest, where I live, is actually pretty good. You can see there's quite a lot of farming done, even up into the mountains, which is unbelievable. So, and this is along the river here, the Columbia River, and then up into Washington. So actually Washington does a tremendous amount of farming. So one of the reasons that this really got to be a hot topic for me personally is because I used to live in California. My sister lives out in the Bay Area. My friend lives in Sacramento. And I drove through California one time, and I noticed there was basically nothing on any of the trees. I drove for 100 miles all the way into San Francisco, and for many hundreds of miles, there was nothing on either side of the road. And I was like, what's going on? This is 80%, 90% of our produce, and yet there was nothing on the trees. There was, like, sand. It was really disastrous. And what I noticed here is you can see these gray areas, this pocket right in here, is all farmland that has been devastated. There's no longer water, enough water in California to farm here, and the sand itself has been so heavily farmed that this is actually called fallow land. And it actually goes all the way down into here. You can see, we're gonna look at some of the details in a moment, but that's what scared me. So it started to scare me because our best farmland in the United States is falling apart. We need to find an alternative to California. And that's what we're going to try to look at here and kind of raise some really important questions about us, right? We can all, the crazy thing is that everyone can make a huge difference. So You know, I know one person in my town, and they supply food to hundreds or even thousands of people. That's just one person, and that's pretty much how farming works. One person often helps even up to millions of people in some of these farms that we're going to look at. So what we're looking at here is the Sacramento area, and the interesting thing about... So I'm really sorry, I'm going to have to cut this conversation off for a moment and take a walk here. But what I wanted to say is this is the most important farming map right here. If you're not familiar with California, why did they put Sacramento as a capital? Well, because farming is the key to everything in California. So I don't know why a lot of Californians complain about Sacramento, but honestly, it was a very good decision because all the rivers converge into the Bay Area, both the northern part of California and the southern part of California drain into the Bay Area. And basically, this region is the most vital farmland perhaps in the United States right now. Now, there are other alternatives like in Florida and Louisiana that perhaps in the future could have better farmland than California. However, right now, this is the map that we're looking at. And basically, you can see there's quite some diversity here. But the actual thing that scared me is that if you notice this purple stuff here, this is grapes. This is all wine. So essentially what's going on here in California is they've converted the farmland to making alcohol. We also see that in Oregon with hops. Some of the most expensive land has been sold off to sell for alcohol in Oregon, as well as grapes here in California, making alcohol as opposed to making food. So that's a very weird question. Because farmers basically can make more money oftentimes making alcohol. And there's very small plots of land in here, and you can see how vast the city is relative to the farmland. It's actually getting to be ginormous, Sacramento here, so, and you can't have farmland there. So I'm going to go through these maps. This is the southern part of California. Actually, it's very, very important. This is outside of Los Angeles. And you can see, actually, Salinas, this little sliver here, being extremely important as well. So a lot of the smaller farmers, essentially the other major problem in California, notice that probably some of the same farmers own all the red property or all the yellow property, or actually even both the red and the yellow. So there's actually, and notice all the purple being actually grapes. So there's actually a major problem going on here, because some of this is not even, this is like corn, or like, actually some of this was going to be cotton. Yeah, so that's not even a crop we can eat. That's for clothing. A lot of this does not need to be cotton. It could be shifted to some other state. So they're just, actually the farmers may be not be doing a good thing. And it may be very centralized with just a few farming families. I looked up one particular farming family that I got some nuts from. They've been the same farming family for four generations. They own like vast majority of the nut industry. And basically, it's like, it's almost like they're gangsters or something. Because there's just like, they own all the land. You can't buy it from them. It would be too expensive to get all the machinery to do it properly as a small farmer and compete against them. So, and even in the wine industry. So some of this is pistachios. I think that might be pistachios there. So, and some other things. But basically what I really wanted to emphasize is the diversity here. Like, why don't we see the diversity of crops? There's actually very few different types of crops, an unbelievably few types of crops. So let me just click on one of these so you can see. This land is fallow and idle land. So you can see these little spots in here. There's actually a huge amount of land that is no longer farmable. That should be scary to you. So that's a huge percentage of the land. And what we can do to get that back is a very important question. So you can see the problem there, and you can see it's even worse in Northern California. You can see this is all rice here, which is great. But again, it raises a question of, is this just one rice farmer that essentially, or how many, what's the variety of rice farmers in this region? Is it primarily, like, did this rice farmer actually mess up? It's possible that this land could have been messed up by this same farmer, and now they're just going to mess up this land too. So, and because it's just such a big industry, many farmers own, you know, 360 acres or more of land just as one farmer. So basically, it really is a big business in a lot of ways. But getting the small farmer back, so this is all bad land. So you can see right here, idle cropland. It's almost bigger. The bad cropland is, and this is why I drove through California and saw there was nothing there, is because I-5, when you drive along I-5, it's basically right through here, and it's all done, the farmland. So, and the reason that the farmland is on this side is because the mountains are on that side, and the water actually runs this way. So you have water on this side, and you don't have water on that side, and that's why this farmland has all gone bad. So, very interesting to look at in Northern California. Now, Louisiana is the kind of the savior of this whole discussion, as well as Memphis here that we're going to look at in a moment, and then the whole Southeast. This is definitely an area, Georgia, Northern Florida, Alabama, and then getting up into South Dakota, or South Carolina, sorry. And then we're going to look at the Midwest. This is actually a really big shame problem. And then actually outside of New York, you can see just very little farmland whatsoever. So all of this, to get food into New York City, you're basically moving it thousands of miles to get to Philadelphia, Washington, D.C., Annapolis. All this is corn. They're not eating corn every day. The yellow means that it's corn or soybeans. This is going to feed cattle, essentially, or even ethanol for cars. If you've been to a gas station recently, farmers are just trying to make money. It's an easy crop to grow, so they grow corn. We may need to entirely redo the industry to require, if you're, you know, more diversity in general, but essentially the East Coast, which is the most populated, doesn't get any food from anywhere except for, guess what, all across the country. Like, because we know from the data here that 80 to 90% of the food is coming from California. So they have to travel many thousands of miles just to get to New York City for the food. Here's where I live in the Pacific Northwest. You can see it's actually pretty complicated. Actually, Idaho is doing a great job. It's really unbelievable. A lot of people don't believe that Idaho is a really good farming state, but to be honest, it's got, notice it's not yellow and it's not green. That means they're actually doing a little bit more diverse crops in Idaho and also in Washington, which is a great sign. So I'm going to break on this conversation for a moment, and then we're going to go back and circle some details and look at a lot of details on these maps. But essentially, take a look at some of this, and we're going to rethink about California here in an amazing way, and maybe rechange the entire future of the farming industry for the United States just in this discussion right now, because this is not working in California. You can see there's a lot of land that really is not looking like in good shape. I did satellite image. You might want to look at satellite imagery. You can zoom in and do street view, and you can see it's just all like sand basically in those regions. Basically there's mountains up through here. So again, this is a tough problem because we got mountains in through here, rivers, we have wildlife and trees that we also need to protect. And essentially it's all been farmed out. And like I showed you in those other images, in this cropland image, everything is farmed. Everything, just keep going on and on and on. It's all been farmed. So don't believe the story that, you know, there's maybe some very important questions that we gotta look at. That's this land that we're looking at right in through here. So, and it's actually, we could do a much better job. You can see they're starting to do more diverse crops up into Canada. I'll be right back. I hope you really enjoyed this discussion. Thank you so much. So I really wanted to thank everybody, you know, that's looking at this, and trying to understand exactly what's going on. You know, it is, in many cases, an emergency, you know, for so many people, in terms of our health, right? Because we're not, we have to be very healthy and eat really good quality food. Hello, everybody. So I wanted to finish up the discussion here. Well, that's not the right way to explain it. Really, just begin the discussion and really try to figure out what the next even more fun steps are, which is basically making friends with some farmers and getting to know people in some of these specific areas and actually starting to do things. I have a bunch of different diagrams. Basically, I wanted to start with a crop calendar, though, just to remind. So basically, you have the planting season, which starts in April and then shifts all the way to June or July. And then you have a separate planting season right here at the end, as well as a harvesting kind of done in October, September, and even at the end of August, depending on the crop. So I just circled some of the regions here so you can kind of see basically how small the farmland is actually that we have available. And actually this gets quite cold up north here, you know, once you get further north. So basically this region here also gets very dry down in Texas as well. So even parts of this need to be removed from this diagram. And then I just wanted to emphasize, here's an example of Chicago, and you can see if we zoomed in here that every single thing has been farmed. And then kind of looking at the different regions here, specifically, you don't really get a concept of how important Canada is or Mexico at all on this. So, but basically California is essentially part of Mexican farming, as well as Texas and Louisiana. So really, the interesting thing is that Florida basically gets into the Caribbean and actually starts to change the topic entirely to fish, which actually we should be very cautious about. Some areas have been completely fished out. So, but each one of these areas are very important to look at. And then here you can kind of see some of the area out west, as well as just the vastness of what happened here. So basically people are just pushing way up into Canada. And this is actually very simple types of farming being done because it's just cold or either too dry sometimes. So, and you can basically see the soil map. We basically only have two major regions, which is here and there. The rest of this is very dry, but this pink soil and soil like this being pretty important. And then I wanted to re-look at these dead farm zones here in California. So you can see the whole valley, basically the West Valley, is almost completely becoming unfarmable. And that's because of water. So the mountain range runs right up the coast here. If you see here, you can see these high mountains here basically drain into these rivers. And then that means that only this side, because 80 to 90% of all the produce not only comes from California, but also it's like 95% irrigated. So it's either coming from groundwater deep in the ground, or it's actually coming from, which is not necessarily sustainable because those wells will run out of water. And that's exactly what's happened here. So but it's actually even worse than what you think. It's not just water. It's actually the soil is actually sand. And you can see here, the most important region in Sacramento. Anyway, so I'm sorry I'm going through this so fast, but I hope you'll have some time to look at all the details here. So if you're interested in California or working with Californians, certainly there is a lot of need here in Southern California, and even hope, because the mountains are actually taller here on this side. And then that means there's more water, so there's actually a better chance to save some of these farms because the water is actually maybe better on that side. And here you can see just the vastness of all the sand areas in California. And this is actually what I would call United States' most critical farms down in Louisiana and all in this region here. We actually get into sugarcane farming, which you also see in Florida, and it's actually almost extensively sugarcane through there. And then this area being extremely important, if we look at the map here, sorry, give me 1 second. So we're basically talking about this region right in here. The diversity of the farms is very important to consider. So this actually could help the entire United States just by solving one problem in a farm here. You can basically start to really make a major impact in helping farming all around the United States, just right in there. And then there's a lot of new farms basically right here. I call this the farming incubator because there's a lot of deforestation going on here, as well as new farms, particularly even in Alabama, actually needs a lot more discussion on farming, certainly, as well as Mississippi. So there's definitely a lot of room for farming in there because you have a river there that definitely has a lot of water, Mississippi River and so on. So basically Jackson here, Mobile, all these coastal towns, everything could be really worked on. And this is really where the problem, the ironic truth is that there's a lot of farmland here, but it's all been done with corn, and there's really a very, it's such a serious discussion because we really could radically, the entire farming situation in the United States has kind of evolved into ethanol, corn, and soybeans. It's terrible. So that's a huge discussion. And then here, this is really one of the most important regions because there's such a heavy population. If you look at the population density here, it's all, this is where the most densely populated part is of the United States. And these farms are very important. You can see there actually isn't a lot of diversity. It's actually just corn and soybeans again. So there's serious need for improvement there. A lot of farmers, my friend used to work outside of New York City, and they had a farm, and then they supplied New York City with food. And then here again, here's the West Coast. And then looking at the deforestation, you can see all these pink areas. It's amazing. So anyway, so I hope you appreciate this conversation. Definitely look at some of these maps. I'll try to post them as soon as possible and get to some discussions and work with you on some things. Thank you so much. I'm very thankful. See you later. And again, no matter where you are in the world, these maps are really helpful. I'm going to zoom out here so you can see the perspective here. And believe it or not, United States is the biggest part of the farming puzzle, really. But it's not the whole truth. Wow, that really crashed my computer. It's not. So basically, you can see the area of the farmland is not always significant because a lot of this farmland, as you can see, all of this was essentially corn and soybeans, which is basically used to feed cattle. So that happens almost everywhere, sadly, specifically down in Argentina. There's a lot of problems, but you get more diversity in the farmland, essentially in China and India and in Africa and along the equator in general. So you start to have fruit, you start to have more natural fruits, more organic farming techniques, and just a lot more important concepts. But anyway, thank you so much. And we just looked at a major part of the farmland of Earth. And hopefully if you're in one of these regions, you can definitely start to work on some things. And I definitely would like to talk with people, particularly in the Southeast and the South here, as well as along the West Coast and here where I live, out in Washington and Idaho area, which is right in here. I'm definitely interested in working with you and talking with you about what's going on in your neighborhood or in your farm, or even in your local grocery store. I always try to check out what's going on. I look at exactly where the farm is. Sometimes I try to look them up on the internet and do a little bit of research. Like my pineapple recently came from a company in Florida that actually got their pineapples from Costa Rica. So that was an interesting little discovery, just to see how the food system works. But anyway, thank you so much. And please let me know what we can do. And I'd be glad to try to work with you on all kinds of aspects of this. And so please try to be my friend. Let me know what you're doing on farming. And let's talk. Thank you so much. And I wanted to remind everybody about the wildlife situation. I went through a huge discussion of farming in the jungle and even population in the jungle, both the Amazon and the Congo. And there is a lot of hope in Central America to pull some of these farms that are going into the jungle back up into Mexico and back up here. So helping people make better decisions about where to farm. And even the United States can make a huge impact just in the southeast here by farming here and offering to bring some of the farmers up here so they don't have to farm so close to the jungle. There's definitely some opportunities to work together, and Mexico is hugely important on that, especially the Yucatan Peninsula. All of this area is still just fresh virgin area that is major forest, but honestly it's better to farm here in the Yucatan than it would be to farm directly in the jungle, so there needs to be some compromise. A lot of those farms are actually right along the coast here, as you can see, and over here near the south near Texas. But Mexico plays a huge role. If 80% of our food comes from California, in many cases, in terms of produce, Mexico is even closer to the equator and has much more water and rain than California. So the farmland is way better in Mexico, and that's why Mexicans provide a lot of the food as a backup to California. But anyway, this conversation was primarily about the United States, and we looked at just about everything. We looked at the soil maps. We looked at all of the details in terms of the crops. I tried to zoom in here. And then we looked at California in specific. We looked at the Central Valley of California. We looked at the south part near Los Angeles. And then we looked at the north part and studied some of the details here, as well as all the rice farming here, pistachios, and some other things. You may want to actually zoom in very carefully and look at all these details. Louisiana was a very important part of this conversation because it's really the most critical farming area in the United States, because all of the farms drain into this region. All the waste, all the pollution, everything comes down to Louisiana. And that discussion actually starts in Memphis, which is the center here of the entire United States' farming policy and everything. So basically, here's the southeast, and this is all the new farmland that we tried to look at, and you can see all the sugarcane farming going on down here in Florida. So you have some unbelievably good farmland, and also natural wildlife as well. So, and then we talked about the very significant problem of farming in the Midwest, as well as ideas of urban farming, which basically go into this area here outside of New York City, and then the West Coast, more of the West Coast, as well as some other things. So thank you so much, and I hope to talk with you and work on this with others and try to continue the conversation as much as possible. Thank you so much. And again, I wanted to re-emphasize the importance of the wildlife question here. You know, this little land that we got down in Florida is very critical. If we do this farming correctly here, we can make huge, even though I pointed out that this is where the new farmland is, this is also where we can make the biggest mistakes, because we start to get into the ocean. And once we make a mistake there and in the jungle, it could be absolute catastrophe. So, but there's definitely some other options to think about. Thank you so much.